Let us solve another question which was given in 2015 for 2 marks. Let us see this. Consider the following code sequence having 5 instructions I12, I5. Each of these instructions has the following format: operation followed by RI, RJ, RK, where operation is performed on the contents of register RJ and RK, and the result is stored in register RI. So, these are the source register, this is the source register, this is the destination register. So, we know that. And now, there are 5 instructions given: I1, I2, I3, I4, I5. There are a few assertions made: S1, S2, S3. The statements that are given here is S1, S2, S3. We need to find out which is true, which is false. Okay. Now, here, the question is, the statements are, there is an anti-dependence between instructions I2 and I5. So, we need to find out if there is an anti-dependence between I2 and I5. There is an anti-dependence between instructions I2 and I4. We need to find out if there is an anti-dependence between I2 and I4. Within an instruction pipeline, an anti-dependence always creates one or more stalls. So, these are the 3 statements. We need to find out which is true, which is false. Obviously, we can fix for S3. S3 is always true because whatever the dependence, either it could be anti-dependence or it could be any other dependence. Every time when there is a dependence, there will definitely be a stall. All right? So, in that light, S3 will always be correct. Right? You can clearly see there are 3 kinds of a data dependencies. I will let it here. Data dependencies are 3 kinds. One is true dependency. One more is anti-dependency. And one more is output dependency. Okay. This can also be called as RAW, read after write, and write after read. This is called write after write, WAW. For an example, the instructions for the first one, true dependence, I'm going to give it here. For a true dependence, the example is x is equal to y plus z. This is the first instruction. Second instruction is A is equal to x plus c. That means that the first instruction, the x is the destination register. So rather destination operand. In the second instruction, x is one of the source operands. Okay. That means that here this is the output. Here this is one of the operands. Here there will be a problem because when you want to insert these 2 instructions in the pipeline, there will be a problem. Unless this instruction gets executed, this instruction cannot get its operand. Okay. The first one's result is next one's source. So, this is what? True dependency. That means that the first one's output is second one's input. Anti-dependence is, you reverse this. That is, A is equal to X plus C and X is equal to Y plus Z. In this, in the first instruction, X is a source. Second instruction, X is the destination. So here, the instruction which is used as a source operand in the first instruction will be updated by the second instruction. This is called an anti-dependence. Okay. Finally, the output dependence. What is output dependence? X is equal to A plus B. X is equal to C plus D. Here, both times X is getting updated. So, this is called RAW, read after write. This is called write after read. This is called WAW. Here, X must be written first, then followed by X must be read. Read after write. Okay, the value of the X must be written and then followed by X can be read by the next instruction. And the second one is, the first instruction should read the X right? Because it is a source operand. Then only second instruction will be able to write the X. The order must be sustained and followed strictly. WR in this. Okay, WAW. First instruction should write, followed by second instruction. First instruction should update X, followed by second instruction. This is a true dependency. This is an anti-dependency. This is an output dependency. Okay, let us see. First, we'll have to look at if there is an anti-dependence between instruction I2 and I5. What is an anti-dependence? The anti-dependence is like this. The first instruction source will be the next instruction destination. Okay, that is anti-dependency. Here you have a look at first instruction source, R1 and R2. Second instruction, I5. We need to check between I2 and I5 if there is an anti-dependence. So if for I5, the resultant register is one of the registers from R1 and R3, then there will be anti-dependence. That is, the registers which are being used as a source here will be used as a destination. But here, R7 is something different from R1 and R3. So there is no anti-dependence here. Once again, anti-dependence is, if an instruction used as a source register in the first instruction, and the same register will be used as a destination register in the subsequent instruction, then there is an anti-dependence. Here there is no anti-dependence because the source registers and the destination registers are different here. Okay, in I2 and I5. So the first statement is false. The second statement we'll see. There is an anti-dependence between I2 and I4. So let us again see. I2, the source operands are R1 and R3. For I4, if one of these registers from R1 and R3 is the output register, then there will be a problem. So here you can see that R3 is the destination register here. R3 is one of the source registers from I2, and this is the destination register in I4. So there is an anti-dependence. That means that S2 and S3 are correct. S2 and S3 are correct. Okay, that means S1 cannot be true because there is no anti-dependence. S2 is correct because there is an anti-dependence between I2 and I4 because I2 source is I4's destination. Okay, so S2 is correct. S3 is also correct. So the option is D.